I'm Yaneli Espinal with another FinCap Friday brought to you by NextGen Personal Finance. 5G wireless data or fifth generation wireless data is starting to become available in more and more places. It's been advertised as up to 20 times faster than 4G and LTE data. And it's supposed to allow for way more people and devices to be connected to the internet at the same time. People with AT&T service may have already seen a little 5GE logo appearing on their phone. But don't get it twisted, that is not 5G. In February of 2019, Sprint actually filed a lawsuit against AT&T over this little symbol. They say it's straight up lying to customers because 5G hadn't even come out yet. But AT&T says 5GE is different. It stands for 5G Evolution, which is not the same thing as 5G. But regardless of which company you think is right or wrong, there's a lot of buzz in the media about 5G data. So here's what you need to know. Only new 5G compatible phones and devices will be able to get this faster service. And not only do you have to pay for that new device, but you also have to be ready to cough up an extra fee for the 5G with your monthly phone bill. 5G is very, very expensive to roll out because it requires companies to change or upgrade all the old equipment and hardware to support this faster, newer technology. And that ain't cheap. Since it's so pricey, companies are taking it slow. Verizon announced it was launching 5G just in Chicago and Minneapolis first, and then it would expand to about 30 other cities by 2020. They are the first to officially offer 5G, but back in January 2019, Verizon's 5G demo was not as fast as the media hyped it up to be, which has a lot of people wondering, are these companies just rushing to be the first to offer 5G and not making sure that it's actually high quality service? Only time will tell.